Imagine an AI tool that lets you design visually and refine your ideas on infinite canvas with full customization options just like in Figma, but powered by AI to speed up your design workflow. Well, let me introduce you to MagicPath, and it's the first AI tool I've seen that is truly made for web and UX UI designers. Instead of working in a single static canvas or being stuck in the overwhelming chat prompts, MagicPath gives you freedom to explore your designs visually and refine them in real time. When building a product, I believe designers should concentrate on the design and UX rather than spending hours in texting prompts to code what they want. In this tutorial, I will show you how MagicPath works and why I believe it's gonna shake up the design industry. Hi, my name is Sergey. Welcome to my channel. Please don't forget to like the video if you like it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And now let's dive in. Okay, so when you're logged in, you'll see this screen. Basically, this is your work zone and you see canvas here. And please note that you don't see any text input fields. This is so cool. On the left side, you'll see a nav bar. You can like close it and open it. You'll see how many components left. In MagicPath, component equals to, well, it's sort of like a frame. We'll see it a little bit later, but you need to understand that it's not like a frame, a static frame in Figma. Component is actually like a page of your website, that something is going on there. And if you want to have like different pages and different experiences, for example, experience of homepage and then experience of logging in, or for example, a shopping cart or something like that, it's called flows. I'll show it to you in a second. So basically what we want to do, we want to click here, we just double click, or we click here like plus button, and we'll see our first component. You see, it looks very similar to Figma, which I love, and the canvas looks like Figma, right? So it looks like just regular design tool that we had, like Sketch or again Figma. And now you can change the resolution. So for example, I want a browser and I want to ask MagicPath. So basically here I can prompt what I want to do. You can use these options just for a test, but the interesting thing is that we can try to do something by ourselves, right? So I have already a prompt ready. Let me just paste it here. So what I want to do, I want to design a professional dashboard, a screen for food tracker. It's a SaaS product with some information here that it should show the trends, blah, blah, design requirements, clean, modern, professional look, scalable design, responsive layout, colors, fresh palette, greens, blues, oranges, stuff like that. A light and dark mode. So I'll prompt it right now, so I'll just set the prompt, but please look at these two buttons here. One is the image, we can add reference, and we can use design systems. But let's try to do it with this prompt without adding anything else. And I want you to show, I want to show you how long will it take for it to actually make the design. So I have my iPhone here. So I press start and I press start here. All right, so it's planning the design, but we can actually do something else. So here we can do another prompt. So basically this thing is working right now, but we can play around with something else. This is so cool. And again, I'm on the browser. You see, I can like move it around. And in this case, I want to have, and I want to use, for example, this screenshot of the cryptocurrency marketplace trading platform. So I'll prompt it like create crypto trading dashboard, use reference, and let's hit it. Currently, we see like two projects are working on. Let's go to design system over here on the top. And this is so cool. Here we can choose a pre-made design systems. For example, OpenAI, Claude, and Airbnb. and we can use them for designing our layouts, basically. And also we can tweak them here, like we can change colors, and then we can use, we can save this as a new design system and use it for our project. For typography, currently it uses only Google Fonts. For the effects, we can play around with border radius. I want to have something like really round things. For example, let's put 5, you see, really round, but we can use like 2, for example. And let's save it as a test. So I said that there's a test design system. Actually, you can import your own design systems from Figma. You just only need to use variables to put it here. So basically you copy, you export CSS from Figma. You see, now we got the design and it's 6 minutes, right? So it took it about 6 minutes to get this dashboard. And look at this, this looks pretty cool. So it has everything. It has the name, Nutri Track. Welcome back, Alex. You see, it has everything here. It added images, you see, from Unsplash. It added icons. You see, icons look pretty cool. Has a dashboard. Click on this frame or component. I can even play around this, you see, with the buttons here. And I can like move around. So it's not a static image. Actually, it's working, you see. Add mill. You see, it shows me that the name is required. So basically, it's already working app. It's crazy. And now let's check it out in web. So basically, I can like press here on this globe icon and I can check it out in like web. You see, I can send it to someone to see this and to play around with it. You see, I can see the weights, calories. We didn't tell him anything about this. So it's just the MagicPath made it. It's all AI. It's crazy. It's really cool. I believe this will work very good for like product owners for testing like MVPs or something like that. And then you can use this to design, like to fine tune it in your favorite design app. But let's see what we can do with this. We can edit this component. So when I press edit, I can now, you see, choose anything in this design. So I can go and see the divs, the H3, you see everything is here. So for example, I want these cards here. I want to change the appearance. So basically I can change the color of them to, for example, more beige kind of thing. You see, I can like changing them. Oh, it changes the stroke, actually the stroke. And here's the background color. Yep, so I go to this color and I can change it, and you see it changes like inside, so I don't have to prompt it. It changes like inside, and this is so cool. It changes everywhere where it has this style. And now I can play around with the, let's see, oh hold on, let's see if I can change the background. The background, oh, it's solid. I'm not sure where to find it, but still it looks pretty cool. And here I can even change the type. Oh, not the type, the tag, the copy. Oops. Alexander, you see. And I can change the name, IO, for example, you see. And let's check it out in web again. Let's see if it works in dark mode. Yeah, it works in the dark mode. So it made the dark mode as well. This is so cool, guys. This is really nice. And you don't even have to go to Figma now, because, well, you see, I press saved, and I guess it took one of my my components, right? But what I can do now, I can get the code. Right, but I need to have a pro version, because currently I'm on free version here on the free plan, and the pro plan costs $20 and the teams for $30. For $20 you can export code and you can import it to Cursor, for example, and give it to developers, basically, right? So they can work with it. Also, I can create variants of this dashboard. And the pro tip here, you can copy this thing just in case you want to have a different variations for it. So I press copy, and here I guess I can paste, right? So I'm pasting in, and now I can like play around, make a different variations. For example, I can change colors or something like that. So let's ask MagicPath, and let's use design system with, for example, Claude design system, and change design system. And now I guess it should update the design system with the one we just picked. Also, let's check out how responsive this is. You see, it looks pretty good. So we have tablet and the full screen, like HD, and I guess it has the mobile, right? So looks pretty good. All right, so we got the updated dashboard and the new design system that we used Claude. So basically you can see it over here. You see it changed the colors, some typography styles, and looks pretty good. But I kind of like the first iteration even more. Also, you can see that the component looks like a frame, like an actual iframe. And you can see it's like a window of the product. And to have, for example, other pages, like, for example, like meals, you need to prompt it. So basically you need to select the meal, and then you can ask MagicPath to create a meals page right inside. So after that, it will be clickable and you can like go inside. But if we're talking about flows is like an experience, like a different experience. For example, that we want to have a registration for this, right? Or we want to have for example, a profile or menus and settings. And now in that case, we'll need to have a flow. So we create a flow, and basically we press here and we can describe the flow. For example, let's use with this style. I kind of like it more, so we'll use it here. So create flow, and I'll put here add a profile section, and that's it. So now it's running. So after a few minutes, we got this second flow, and here we can see it's a profile settings. We can edit profile. Let's check this out in our web browser. See, it's even got the animations. We can switch goals, preferences. We can check out everything here. It's not editable, but still it looks really cool. And I can't play with that, but still it looks very cool. I can press edit, and now I can edit everything. Can you imagine that? So it works perfectly. So basically this is already made front end, and we can pass this to our developer to apply it to a backend and to connect it to a backend. And this is super cool. So I saved it, and we can even see the notification that it's saved. All right, so we have our crypto trading dashboard ready. It was a very complicated design and had a lot of things inside, but actually it copied everything. It copied the logo and things here, but the chart visualize, you know, would be rendered here. So it's not rendering the chart, but let's see how it looks in the browser. And wow, this is so cool. Yeah, so we can switch around, so we can see BTC, like Bitcoin, Solana, Tone. You see, we can even put numbers in. Well, not letters, it should be numbers. And yeah, it looks very cool. You see all the hovers, overview, feed. Unfortunately, visualization is not working, but Other than that, it looks pretty cool. It has the top menu. You see the drop downs. Everything works. Here we can see all the hovers. It's amazing. So we actually got this ready, and yeah, we can pass it to, again, to a developer to connect it with the backend to get the real results, to connect it with the API. So I think this is really interesting thing that we're getting here, and this is completely changing the workflow of the designers, and it becomes a new way to work. So basically, we're not just texting prompts and changing the designs by texting, right? We can actually change the parts of the design using tools that we're used to and that we can see in other graphic design or I don't know, design apps. And this is really interesting that we can get this structure and we can get the idea from the AI and then tweak it using all these options. Also, this is gonna work really good if you're, for example, presenting to a client some ideas. For example, if you're signing a contract and the client asks you to see, for example, three variants of the homepage. So basically, you don't need to spend a day to design these home pages and then not getting paid. You can actually prompt it here. You can get three different variants and you can show it to the client and tell him that this is what I can do, this is the idea, and then you can design all of the pages of the website using MagicPath, or you can get the ideas and transfer them, for example, to Figma to have more options of like manually designing things. But other than that, I believe this is a game changer, and I see it as a huge an impactful tool in the industry right now. So we'll see how it goes, and we'll see what other changes and updates they're gonna have in the future. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you like it. And don't forget to check out MagicPath. The link will be in the description below. And also don't forget to like the video if you like it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye.